Go ahead and get started. So hello everyone, welcome to the Brooklyn Public Library. Thanks for tuning in to join us today. My name is Jane Matchak. I work to support Brooklyn Public Library's Justice Initiatives team in programming and services for those impacted by the carceral system. Today's presentation is the second in our series of Know Your Rights workshops. The series began last week with our partners at Legal Action Center's workshop on rights and liberties of those with conviction histories and who have been harmed by the criminal legal system. And with each Know Your Rights workshop, we'll focus on a current specific topic, whether it might be on one's rights surrounding housing, immigration, encounters with the police, et cetera. But today's presentation will focus on early voting here in New York and citizens' rights around Election Day. We are grateful to have our partner at the New York City Campaign Finance Board, or CFB. CFB's New York NYC Votes campaign brings voter registration, events, and civic engagement programs to all five boroughs with a particular focus on historically disenfranchised communities as mandated in the city charter. The Campaign Finance Board also administers New York City's matching funds program, which incentivizes more local candidacies and in turn amplifies the voices of New Yorkers by matching smaller campaign contributions with public funds. And they also produce the nonpartisan New York City Voters Guide, which provides ballot and candidate info, how to vote, where to vote, info about youth voting. I mean, they really cover it all. And with that, we have Matthew George Pitt with us today, who works for the New York City Campaign Finance Board's Partnership and Outreach Unit, which is responsible for providing New Yorkers with the information they need to engage purposefully in the electoral process through a number of programs that I'll let Matthew perhaps talk about in his own words. So with that, I'll turn it over to you and we can get right into it.
Thank you. So I'm Matthew Pitt with the New York City Campaign Finance Board. I serve as the engagement coordinator working with the Partnership and Outreach Unit. And just a small synopsis of what we do within that unit is we secure partnerships with corporations, government agencies, and mostly community-based organizations in order to reach New Yorkers throughout the city. The reason why we employ this method is because we're a very small unit, roughly three people. So we believe it's beneficial to have partners, mostly CBOs, to assist us in our work. And also a lot of New Yorkers interact with CBOs on a day-to-day basis, and they've built up a rapport in a relationship with them, and there's a level of trust there as well. So we often contact these organizations as a pretty much point of contact for those particular neighborhoods.
Great, thanks so much. We can jump right in to presentations on early voting, whatever you'd like to discuss first thing.
Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna just discuss a few things regarding knowing your voting rights and also how to vote in New York City as well. So as was said earlier, New York City Votes and the New York City Campaign Finance Board. New York City Votes is really just the nonpartisan voter engagement arm or the initiative of the New York City Campaign Finance Board, which was stated earlier as assisting all New Yorkers with regards to voting. We also have a separate division that also handles campaign finance and public financing of candidates who also run for citywide offices and as well as the borough-wide offices and the city council as well. Now, just to go over a small synopsis on how to vote in New York, you don't have to actually wait until Election Day to vote this fall. Remember, you have other options when it comes to voting. One of them is early in person, which is just started on Saturday and should be continuing until November 1st. It's about 10 days, so please make sure if you can't make it to the polls on Election Day, but you can make it there between now and then, to please do so. Um, Additionally, we also have by mail or early, I'm sorry, by mail slash, sorry.
No worries. Love those.
Apologies. So another way that folks can also vote without having to go to the poll site on election day is also voting by mail as well. So this is more or less through absentee ballots. You can always request a ballot, I think, to the Board of Elections before October 27th in order to vote by mail. Once you do receive the ballot, we're asking all New Yorkers to follow the instructions carefully as you see it on the ballot. Use a black and blue ink pen. And also additionally, please mail it as soon as you get it. I'll fill it out and mail it as soon as you get it. You can also drop this, you can also drop it off at a poll site on election day, or you can drop it off at the local Board of Elections office within your borough. Or you can also drop it off at early voting on a poll site as well. And of course, there's always the traditional option of voting on election day. It should be on November 3rd. Poll sites are always open from 6 a.m. to 9 p.m. Now for early voting, remember all registered voters can vote early this fall. Polls will be open from October 24th to November 1st, as I said earlier. Remember that your early voting poll site will be different from your election day poll site. There's only 88 sites throughout the city. So please make sure you double check before you go. And the best way to do it is to go to the Board of Elections website, which you can see here, findmypollsite.vote.nyc. Additionally, there's also voting by mail. As I said before, you can request an absentee ballot. The request should be put into the Board of Elections by the 27th. Of October. And additionally, while you're filling out the ballot, since you have to have an excuse, the excuse that you can mark at this time can be temporary illness or disability, which includes the risk of contracting the coronavirus. Additionally, if you're a student or you're away on business or you're at the hospital during election day or any other situations that you might be having that ensures that you can't go to the poll on election day, you can also mark those as well. Additionally, after you complete the ballot, please make sure you sign, date, and seal the absentee ballot envelope as well, and mail it off as soon as you can. And of course, the traditional route, voting in person on election day. This year, we're expecting significantly high turnout, and we're also expecting that lines will be long at some poll sites, which we've already begun to see at early voting poll sites. So if you're worried about the crowds, we're recommending that you vote early. As I said earlier, poll sites will be open from 6 a.m. to 9 p.m. And please note that the Board of Elections has prepared extensively to keep all poll sites safe during this time. Remember, masks and social distancing are required. Surfaces will be regularly cleaned with disinfectant. Hand sanitizers will be available for everybody. And poll workers will be behind plexiglass. Now, there are certain extensions of voter rights that you'll see here in the state of New York. And, you know, a lot of people are not aware of what those rights are. So we have a guide on our website that sort of like gives you just a detailed list of what your rights are as a voter. And one of the things you should note is that if you were formerly incarcerated and you have finished your time at a New York City corrections facility, you do have the right to vote after you finish your maximum sentence. Additionally, if you're also on parole, you can also request a conditional pardon, which allows you to register to vote and to vote as well. For anyone who is on parole, I would suggest you contact your parole officer to find out more information. Additionally, we also cover basic requirements for those who are also registering to vote. So remember, you have to be 18 years of age or older to register to vote and to vote. However, if you're 16 or 17 years old, you can pre-register to vote using the same form. However, you will not be allowed to vote until you turn 18. Additionally, we also cover rights for survivors of domestic violence who may be requesting who's going to make a request to have their voting records sealed from the public. Remember, your voter registration form can be made public. So you can actually make the request to have them sealed if you have a court order stating that you are a victim of domestic violence. And additionally, for folks who are homeless or experiencing homelessness, you can also register to vote and vote. What you will need to do is you will have to have a mailing address. And additionally, you will also have to mark down a place where you can be found. So whether that's a shelter, your friend's place, your family member's address, or a park bench in Central Park, all of those things are valid as well. What to expect when you're at your poll site. When you do get to your poll site, you'll need to be doing three things. One is to check in. And as I said earlier, there are certain safeguards that are put in place now at each poll site. This includes both early voting locations and election day poll sites. So one thing you'll need to do is to check in with the poll worker at the front desk. Make sure you receive your ballot. Make sure you sign off on the book as well. And please make sure you take a look at the ballot, both sides. There's a lot of people who don't realize that there's two sides to a ballot. So please check both sides to make sure that you filled everything in, scan it in, and once you're done, make sure you get your I voted sticker and show it off. And that's it. If you've got questions, we always have answers. You can always check out our website, Voting in NYC, at www.voting.nyc. And if you don't see an answer to your question on our website, then you can always follow us on Twitter, Instagram, or Facebook, and you can always ask us questions there. You can also feel free to send us an email or a phone call, and we will contact you via those methods as well. Thank you.
Thank you so much. That was really useful information for next week and right now, even with early voting kicking off. A couple of questions that came up during that, feel free to just stab at what you might or might not know. But one is, what if polls are obviously day of, open 6 to 9 p.m. What if you're in line at 9 p.m. still, expecting that the lines might be longer than usual? And if you are there kind of late, what's the best advice?
You can still go into the poll site and vote if you're there at 9. Generally what happens is 15 minutes or so before the polls close, the poll worker comes out and sort of like makes an count of who got there before 9 p.m. And we'll probably try to speed you guys along, make sure you guys get in and vote. I think some of them might actually give you a ticket before you go in, but I'm not too sure about that.
Okay, thanks. And then in New York, do you have to show any form of ID, especially right now? And does a New York City, NYC IDs, do those count for showing ID?
If you're a first-time voter and the Board of Election wasn't able to identify your identity through the form, so on the form, you're asked for two pieces of identification. One is the state identification number that's on your driver's license or your state ID. And the second one is the last four digits of your social security number. If they weren't able to confirm you using either of those two methods, then you'll be asked to present identification when you get to the poll. All you have to do to all you have to present is an ID with your name and face on it, and a utility bill or a bank statement or a piece of mail that has your name on it, as well as your address.
Okay, cool. Just like going to the DMV, it sounds like. And yeah, great reminder. 17 of the Brooklyn Public Library branches will be polling sites this year. So especially if you're looking for your poll site, need a place to cast the ballot or even drop off mail-in ballots, definitely double check, because branches all over the city are gonna be open for polling that day. So yeah, thank you so much. Those were the questions I had come in. Let me double check, see if I'm missing anything else.
Polling sites this year.
But besides that, I think that might be all the questions that we got. But yeah, thank you again so much for talking a little bit about what we have ahead of us next week. If there's anything else that you wanted to mention, just maybe about what the campaign finance board, you know, what partnerships or outreach might look like after the election, or kind of what do you guys do, you know, when there's not a presidential election coming, but kind of the meantime and intermittent between now and, you know, house voting in 2 more years.
Mostly what our agency's focus on is city elections. So between now and June of next year, we'll be focusing on the mayoral and the other citywide elections that are going to be happening in June of next year and also November. So one thing that I do want to make sure everyone is aware of is that ranked choice voting will go into effect. I think folks in the Bronx should see it first in February of 2021. And the Campaign Finance Board will be doing an outreach and an education campaign around what ranked choice voting is, how to vote, and some of the more basic facts about ranked choice voting as well. So that's going to be our main focus, is sort of increasing voter turnout for the June election next year and also the November election as well.
Great. Yeah, no, that's good to hear. And I think a lot of people who, you know, might not be super enthused about voting in particularly one election or another, to keep the reminder that there's always, you know, there's always things being voted on, especially at the city and state level, that are really important and really key to like affecting, you know, Brooklyn communities directly. And that there's always going to be something to have your voice heard on. So thank you so much for sharing a lot of that. And we'll look forward to what you guys have coming up, you know, right now and in the future with mayoral elections next year. And again, yeah, if anyone has any questions for Campaign Finance Board or any of their various programs that are happening now or in the future, whether you have questions about the processes or you'd like to get involved, we'll have all of the Finance Board's information for links to get on their site and stuff added to this video's description after it's posted. But yeah, thank you so much, Matthew. I hope that this season goes well, everyone stays safe while voting and stays healthy, but also, you know, gets their ballots in and in a timely fashion. So thank you once again.
You're very welcome. Thank you. And I want to do a special thank you for the Brooklyn Public Library for having us here to discuss this important topic.
Always great to have you guys as partners. And for everyone watching, thanks for joining us. Voting election is it a week from today? I think it's a week from today. So yeah, or no, week from tomorrow. But everyone, yeah,